trying to sort the FedShip cooperation. It's been a busy morning. Good morning. My name is Henk de Vries, director of Koninklijke de Vries Scheepsbouw and one of the two CEOs of FedShip. And I've been asked by my lovely marketing people to tell you a little bit about my past. And they prepared a nice book with some old photographs. They don't have a clue what I mean. But I do, and I'm going to walk you right through. The first one, yeah. I remember I was talking to my cousin Tom, who's my partner in crime in the shipyard for over 35 years now. And he said, there is this thing where we sit in a box in the front garden of Oma with tulips. So I said, what? Yeah, because the family of de Vries always was making photographs and films, and it was always... And we are not sitting in a box, that's a different photograph. There is a photograph where indeed we are sitting in a ship, which is probably a cardboard thing in which equipment for a boat was transported. The girl in the picture is my sister Bettina. I think Bettina in this picture is probably 4 or 5, which means that I'm 6 or 7. And cousin Tom, who looks remarkably like his oldest daughter in this picture, is 9 months younger than I am. So I, through my life, I've always been ahead of him. At least that's what I like to think, although Tom is a pretty clever guy. The next picture. Oh, this is great. This was taken by a very famous Dutch fashion photographer. He did some work for my grandfather after the Second World War in the late 40s. Paul Huff is his name. He's very, very famous in the Netherlands. He also made famous photographs of Johan Cruyff, for example, and of Ajax with the way they were posing. And I don't know how the family did this. These are our predecessors, and there's two generations in this picture. In the top, with the head looking into the picture, is my grandfather, Henk de Vries. Some of you may know that my nickname became Henk 3. And it became Henk 3 because when I joined the company, my father was also Henk de Vries, but everybody called him Beep for no apparent reason. His father was retired, but was still in the books of the shipyard, so he was Henk Senior. My father was Henk Beep Junior. Then there was Uncle Henk, who was Henk Johansson, and this is Johan, his father. And Uncle Henk is the good-looking guy to the right there. And so I came in and I was entered into the books of the shipyard as Henk S. de Vries Junior Henkson. That was rather confusing. So I ended up, and that's still on my business card today, with Henk de Vries 3. In the picture further is Gerard, the only person in the photograph who's still alive. All the other guys have passed away. My father, Johan de Vries, who was managing director when Tom and I came up through the ranks, and Tom's father, Kees, with a nice bald head, which he has passed on to all his 3 sons. As you can see in this picture, here is my cousin Sybrand, to the left, who has hair, because this picture was taken quite some time ago. My father passed away in 2004, but he was still a director until 1996. This is definitely when he was still a director. My grandfather, with a little cigarette in hand, because everybody was smoking. The reason we took this photograph is that this is Hendrik Sybrand de Vries, senior. Hendrik Sybrand Beep de Vries. Hendrik Sybrand the third. And Hendrik Sybrand Sybrand. Sybrand was then probably still in school, or at least in college. And he later, but that is not until 2005, so at least 10 years after this photograph, became the first director of the De Vries shipyard in Makkum. Yeah, this is the nice part of my work. This is on board one of the gallant ladies, as we were busy selling the next one. The disadvantage, the boat that I was on was gallant lady number 5. And we had just completed number 6, and this was the negotiations for number 7. In total, we built 8 boats for the family over a period of 30 years. I'm sitting here with the captain of the fleet, Joe Moore, who is with us to this day, and one of his reserve captains, because the Moran family, who owned the Gallant Ladies, always had more captains on their various boats. You can see here in the corner is the specification book with the little markers in it. You see it's quite thick. It was printed on one side so we could easily make notes and also use the blank side to do it also. And these were the first books that were probably bigger then what can I say, maybe 100 pages. These were more than 200. And I'm probably making some calculations because I was not writing the specs in those days. Somebody else in the company was doing that. But I was responsible for the financial side, or it could have been the contract. And we are here in the Bahamas, in a nice bay, working all day and all night. But occasionally we had some time to go for a swim. I paid 10,000 euros for Gaudiamus, which was a wooden sailboat of the IJsselmeer class that my grandfather built in 1933, when my father was 1 year old. And I bought it in 2005, the year after my father passed away. And I thought it was an intelligent spending and investment of my inheritance. I spent the same amount of money that was cost to purchase on restoring it. I have it to this day. On a good day, it's worth 1,000 guilders, maybe. So the investment is sound if you come back to 1933. Wooden boats are very difficult to keep, but they are so lovely. We have now the Fedship Heritage Fleet. I'm a member of that group, about 80 people who have classic Fedships and who restore them, sail them occasionally, sometimes move them on, sell them. Some people have more than one. And I'm a proud member of that group. From a business side, it makes no sense. The sailing is lovely, and it is nice to be able to work for a company that is so old that you can cherish a piece of its heritage. And I like old shit. I'm here in my summer house with analog amplifiers and record players and records on the wall. And I have an old Maserati in the garage. I have an old Rolls Royce that is always breaking down. So I understand the love of old things and the charm of history. By the same token, always looking into the future with the company. But it is good to know where your roots lie. And this is a great example. Terry is famous. Terry is a rock star in superyacht design. This is Tom de Vries, still with some hair. This picture was taken in the early 2000s. And Tom is pinning a gold-plated de Vries logo on Terry's lapel. And that has a very great significance for us. When people work with the company for 10 years, they get a small silver de Vries token. Nowadays it's a crown because the company has become royal. When they work with the company 25 years, they get a gold one. And here we give Terry a gold one because this, in I think it was 2003, probably the launch of High Chaparral, which Terry designed the interior of and a bit of the exterior. And 25 years before, in 1978, Terry did Rio Rita as the first boat with the de Vries family interior. So it was his 25 year with de Vries. So he's not a Fedship employee by no means, but we gave him the pin and he wears it with pride. This is the only picture of one of the most amazing boats that we've ever done that we were allowed to publish. And believe me, we had to do some arm twisting to allow to even publish this. One of the drawbacks for us of the work that we do is that clients value their privacy and are very reluctant to let know-how about their most private asset go out. Venus was groundbreaking in many, many respects. It was the second boat that Fedship did with Philippe Starck, very famous French designer, very French, very famous. And Philippe was responsible for the very straight lines, the uncompromising lack of detail. And what made it worse is that even the small detail that Starck put in, the client told us, no, you have to remove that. This is the first boat with a completely glass superstructure. The boat is 78 meters long. The glass is 30 meters. When we designed the boat, you can still see the frames in the hull at about 3 meters distance. The boat is built on 75 centimeters frame. So that means the structure of the boat is every 75 centimeters. And then the windows is 1.5 meter. The same in the superstructure, 1.5 meter pieces of glass. At a time, there was a famous computer brand that this client was associated with, who built stores completely out of glass. So the client says to us, how much is the distance from the deck to the roof? We said, it's about 3 meters. He said, So in China, you have machines that can make glass 3 meters wide, 12 meters long. shall we do 3 pieces of glass instead of all these 1.5 meter things? We said, did we buy the glass in China? Well, you can buy it anywhere. Anyway, long story short, we ended up working with our glass supplier in Germany. They made special machines. They made special equipment to destructively test the glass for class, for approval. And then we had to explain to class how it works with strength, and we made diagrams in 3D with colors in it. Great picture of the cousins. I like this one. I like especially Tom, who looks a bit like I'm a cool dude. I'm from Aalsmeer and I have a beard, but I'm a cool dude. And I'm cool because I live in Amsterdam, so I don't have to look like that. joking aside, this is Larissa, the boat that is today called W. And Larissa was an exercise in how you could build amazing pieces of quality and craftsmanship in a very intelligent way. The client for this boat was a very knowledgeable industrialist, and he knew what he was asking for. So he gave us the freedom to design something that was very smartly put together, not over the top engineered, but sophisticated without going crazy. And the aesthetics of the boat are simple, but deceivingly simple, because simple can be very expensive. Venus is an excellent example, because Venus looks simple. But man, was this complicated, because I had no detail. Larissa was simple because it was smartly executed. So we could build it economically, but still at superb friendship quality. No standardization, it was completely custom. This is two of my passions in one picture. This is my 1963 Aston Martin DB4, which I took on a trip to Monaco with my friends of RWD Design, and which more recently in 2018 I took on a trip to Scotland. This is the car that is also featured in Skyfall. And we drove it through the Skyfall Valley and took the photographs with my wife as M and me as James Bond. It is standing there in front of Rocket, which is a quite modern boat that we built for a fantastic American client. Sometimes your clients are even more enthusiastic than you are. And the guy who ordered this boat, every time he visited, was a party. I mean, he really made it nice for us. And it shows in the boat. I mean, the quality of the damn thing is amazing. Me with the loves of my life. This is in Italy, in a party of the Boat International Awards. This was when Savannah took home all the prizes for most innovative, best exterior, best interior. Savannah was the first boat that we did, which was completely hybrid, with a lot of attention to drive and efficiency and electricity. Florence, I was thinking about the name of the city. We were in one of the palazzos in Florence where the gala party was. Hendrik, my son in this picture, is about 18. My wife, who is of indeterminate age, as it should be, was with me on that party, and we were sitting at the table with the owner's girlfriend and her entourage, as she was getting more and more excited that every time the boat came up when an award was to be given. De Vries is a family business. I'm fourth generation, and we have quite an age spread in our generation. So our cousins are in their mid-40s. Tom and I are just hitting 60 now. And Hendrik is an example of the fifth generation. He is still in university, blissfully unaware of what may come his way sometime. We have an active program for next gen at the Vries, but we have more in general a very active program in FedShip for connecting with younger people. It is a thing that I find extremely important, and we have in our company a formal forum where 50 plus is forced to sit and listen to 30 minus. And now that we are again in crisis years and we are all of a sudden working from home and learning how to do digital, and for old people like me, we need to listen to the young generations. So I see not only a transition coming in, again making the companies more efficient, more smart in dealing with uncertain circumstances, but I also see an excellent opportunity to make room for the young people in our company in all fields. Thank you. This is a little bit later in my career. When you become more like the CEO of a company and operational directors are more and more running the operations, the worst thing you can do is try to run it for them, because the only thing you know for certain is that you better know than them how to do it. And you can keep doing that until you're 80 and then you die. I decided to let go more, to sometimes bite off my tongue and let things happen. The guy I'm in the picture with went through a similar exercise, but he paid for it the hard way. His name is Mo Gadat. Mo was one of the key figures in Google. And as we are already for a decade trying to sell Google boats, I was interested in this guy, but it found out that he was no longer associated with Google. His son passed away out of nowhere, so he went through a very dark period in his life. And what does this guy do? He writes a book about happiness. And I was very impressed with this book. So when he did a promotion tour in the Netherlands for the translation of his book, I was very happy to receive him at the shipyard, let him do his happiness lecture for the key people in my company, and also promote his book a little bit. And that's, I think, the thing when you get over, let's say 55, it is worthwhile to use the energy and the contacts and the know-how that you have to liaise with other people who've gone through similar exercise in life and try to make the world a little bit better place. This is also in line with the Mo Gadat story, what you start to do when you get older, more experienced, and try to bring a little bit more than just another boat and let other people worry about that. These are the founding people of the Water Revolution Foundation, which is an organization that I hold very dear to my heart. We are trying to make the yachting industry and the superyacht part of it specifically more responsible and more honest and more transparent. And I think really things really got flying when about 4 months after this picture was taken, I had lunch with Peter Luursen, the boss of Luursen Shipyard, our best competitor. And he said, I will join you also, but you and I are going to be here for the long term. And he committed to 10 years supporting the foundation, which of course meant that in Fetchipland, I had to convince my colleagues that we were also in there for a long time. We are, happily so. This picture was taken at the Monaco show. The port is in the back, and FedShip is very good at treating their customers. So I was hosting in our VIP area the group where we had a lovely lunch during the Monaco show. Very proud moment, 2018, the official opening of the Royal Van Lent Shipyard. There is a small line of all important Van Lent people, but because I also have a crown on my head with my company, Queen Maxima also stopped by and made a little conversation. The first thing she says to me, Mr. de Vries, you are still a family business, right? And she knows that because her mother-in-law, Princess Beatrix, is very good friends with Mrs. Heineken. And in the dark ages of yachting in the 60s, my family built a boat for her father, the brewer Heineken. It was a great honor for us to receive the Queen, and she did the official opening of the Royal Van Lent Fetship Facility in Amsterdam in May 2018. And oh yeah, this is also an occasion where I will wear a tie. Looking at the next generation, these kids are all between 16 and 29 at the moment, but there are more. We have dozens of them. So with great faith in the future for FedShip and for the family, I thank you for your attention and listening to me on my trip down memory lane. I close this book.